Warning for cat owners. Yesterday evening, the 24th of July, our cats Zeus and Hades were rushed to the emergency vets for suspected poisoning. Today, we got the call letting us know it's likely they'll never come home. They were one-year-old brothers, and this should never happen to any pet. The suspected poisoning happened in this area, near this area. Please keep your cats safe inside. If you have any reason to suspect your pet has been poisoned, please call your vet immediately. If you have any information you'd like to share or a similar experience, please reach out. Why are people just randomly going out and intentionally poisoning cats? Like, what good does that do you? These cats aren't harming you in any way, shape, or form at all. Like, leave them be. You're ruining their lives and you're making the owners of these cats very sad. Just stop. What's going on, Modertrodes? It's your boy, Long Neil, back again with another new video. And in today's video, we're going over the hot posts from r/IamTotalPOS. Let's get into it. Mom outraged over viral video of bullies pointing gun at son's head. No way. Please tell me that's an airsoft gun. Like, oh, number one, how do these kids even have this gun? Number two, why do they even think it's even remotely smart of an idea to even jokingly point this gun at somebody's head? Like, did they check if it was loaded? If there was already one in the chamber? Is the safety on? Nah, they just think it's funny to point a gun at somebody's head. And then when it accidentally fires, they just go, oh no, oh no. Bruh, no, no. Trump reopening schools, like, some of you may die, but it's a sacrifice I am willing to make. This is the way it should be, though. How long does everyone have to suffer just because a few are weak? What? Basically, what I'm getting from this is you don't want to wear a mask. plain and simple, like, if it's not safe to go to school, then we shouldn't be going to school. Especially when online schooling is so much better and easier now. Like, just do that. We'll all be fine. A 68-year-old got hit with a snowball. Oh, those little rascals. He retaliated by beating a 9-year-old unconscious, police say. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's a totally warranted reaction for getting hit by an accidental snowball. Like, these kids are just having a snowball fight. The guy's walking down the sidewalk, gets hit.
Ah, I don't like snowballs. Oh, nobody ever asked me to play.
And then actually beats a 9-year-old unconscious. Like, bro, get it together. Every dad has a natural inner desire to be the one to deflower their own child. I love how you try to make this innocent by saying deflower. Like, we all know what you mean. And no, every dad definitely doesn't have that natural desire. Like, that's something that is a big, big problem if you think it's natural for people to want to do to their kids. Ugh. It's unpopular among people who just want to have fun and share stuff without stressing over it. A long time ago on Instagram, I reposted another page's photos, and they got super mad at me and tried to make me take them down. I mass reported their page with multiple accounts, so it got taken down, and my page was the only one with the photos. If it weren't for my Instagram, the photos would be lost. Never gave credit, and never will. WTF is wrong with you. TLDR, I stole and am proud of it, because I want to have fun. Really? Like, not only did you not credit them, you intentionally went out of your way to make false claims and get their original content taken down? How does Instagram even let something like this happen? Like, this shouldn't be happening. The account that should be taken down is the one that's stealing this content that this person worked hard on and isn't getting any credit for. Like, come on, dude. Hello, I'm giving Robux for some Nike pictures. Are you interested? How old are you? 13. Yeah, doubt. What's your username? My Roblox? Yeah. I haven't played in a while, but I can friend you. Just tell me your username so I can friend you. If you're actually interested to send, it's Chronicle Angel. Thanks for the info, pedo. outplayed. Oh my gosh. These guys are just disgusting and sad. Like, I hope they get what they deserve one day. To ever smash my fiance's window this morning using a cat and left it dead at my front door, you're effed. I'll give anyone $500 to tell me anything that contributes to who it is. Bro, why? Like, what's wrong with just throwing a rock through the window? Why bring a cat into it? Like, this cat doesn't need to be hurt for your point to be made. I don't even know what the point is anyways. Like, you shouldn't just be going around smashing people's windows out of anger. But to do it with a cat? That's just a whole new level of insanity. Smashing people's Androids, then giving them the iPhone 11. Wow, you're such a good person. Except for the fact that some people don't like iPhones. And you just wrecked their phone and gave them a phone that's basically useless to them. Or to them is a downgrade. So I'm just really hoping these videos are staged like most of the prank channels on YouTube nowadays. And these people aren't actually getting their phones ruined. Cause that would suck. A mother who films her disabled child on TikTok having fun at a theme park is being told that her child wouldn't be missed. Disgusting. Push her off. She's got Downs. She wouldn't be missed. LOL. Maybe she wouldn't be missed by you, but she'd definitely be missed by a lot of other people. Like, sure, obviously, not everybody's missed by everyone because we don't all know each other and blah, 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 yada, yada, yada. But when you're acting like this, you're making it pretty certain that a very, very select few will ever miss you, even a little bit. Cruel owners throw seriously ill dog in the bin and leave her for dead. A dog who was heartbreakingly thrown into a bin and left for dead by its cruel owners was spotted sitting among the rubbish and rescued by a kind stranger. Hey, well, I mean, at least this has a somewhat happy ending. The dog got found. Hopefully this stranger treats it well and nurses it back to health and doesn't treat it like a total absolute worthless thing, because it's not. Like, why do people insist on getting dogs and then the second they act up once, they're like, oh, it's out of the house. Not my problem. Like, that's what you signed up for, dude. Train the dog better. Here's the aftermath of a peaceful protest. Wow. Just wow. Guys. Great, you're protesting. That's awesome. But why do you have to leave your trash all over? Like, who do you think is going to clean that up? You don't just leave trash. It's illegal, literally illegal to litter. And you're just like, oh, well, I don't care. Oh, these people suck. To those on the how dare she not wear a mask train, allow me to stop you from wasting your time. You mean nothing to me. I do not care if you die. You are not my problem or responsibility. You have no value to me. I'll just block you and move on with my day. Go earn some value to someone by sucking some peen. Maybe they'll care if you die because I'm not wearing a mask if I don't want to, even if it directly would save your life. Because as I made clear, I don't care if you live because my freedom to do what I want means more to me than you do. Hope that clears things up for the mask Gestapo. Yes, clears things up for a lot of people. Hopefully your friends and family that see this realize your absolute insanity. But I mean, seems like there's a few hearts and laughs at this. So I'm thinking I'm getting let down here. But really, like, you would intentionally, if I walked up to you and said, hey, if you wear a mask for 5 minutes, it'll literally save my life. You'd spit at me and go, I don't care about your life. Like, you're just a scumbag person then. Plain and simple. And unfortunately, I don't think there's much anybody can do to change that. Hedgehogs being captured, shaved, and roasted while still alive. Ooh, that's tough. The still alive part is really the rough thing there. At least put them out of their misery first. Update. Last night, a 31-year-old woman was stabbed multiple times in an apartment complex on Mont Smith Drive. She died at the hospital. They captured the moment this 35-year-old man was arrested. I'm not sure about the details, but if she was a woman that did not shut up when he told her to and wanted the last word, that changes everything. When a man says, shut up, woman, please shut up. And forget about calling 911. Shut up. I do not feel sorry for a woman that disobeys. The new number for the domestic violence hotline should be 1-800-SHUT-UP. Many innocent men are in jail now because of a woman. They're not innocent. This guy literally stabbed this chick. In what way, shape, or form does that constitute innocent? It was a non-violent act. Don't care how annoying it was. Retaliated with a violent, deadly act. That's a crime. Don't you have the COVID? Why are you out of your house if you have the virus? Do you or do you not? I mean, I didn't go out. All I did was take pics with my family member. But don't you have the virus? Yeah. Wow. This person really just doesn't care about their family then. Like, you have the virus and you're going out with your family in close quarters. Like, nothing's gonna happen? Like, no, just stay inside for 2 weeks. It's not that hard. You're basically intentionally giving your family members the Rona just because, I don't know, you needed to take a picture with them that day? Ugh. All right, Modern Chodes, that's it for the hot post from r/IamATotalPOS. If you enjoyed the video, please make sure to give it a big thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe and turn on notifications. And of course, share this video with your friends. Till next time, peace.